So we will discuss about canine parvovirus infection. If we talk about etiology of this virus, the main causative agent is parvovirus. It is small, 25 nanometer diameter. It is single-stranded DNA virus, and the capsid protein VP1 and VP2, it allow the virus to bind the host cell transferrin receptor. Parvovirus, they are of two types, canine parvovirus 1 and canine parvovirus 2. The canine parvovirus 1 is the minute virus of canines, and the canine parvovirus 2 having subtypes 2A, 2B and 2C. If we talk about the forms of the canine parvovirus 2, then canine parvovirus 2 myocarditis form and acute canine parvovirus 2 enteritis form. The myocarditis form, it occurs in puppies less than 8 week old, which born to the unvaccinated bitches. And the enteritis form, it occurs between the 6 weeks to 6 month of the age. And the dogs older than the 6 month, sexually intact, are more susceptible than the castrated one. The predisposing factor for the canine parvovirus, like lack of passive immunity, intestinal parasites, overcrowded environment, unsanitary conditions and stressful environment. These are the predisposing factor for canine parvovirus infection. If we talk about the breed which are more susceptible to this canine parvovirus infection, include Rottweiler, Doberman Pinscher, Labrador Retriever and German Shepherd Dog. These breeds are predisposing to the infection. If we talk about the pathogenesis of this virus may enter through fecal or oronasal route, then replication occur in lymph node of oropharynx. So this replication occur in lymph node of oropharynx, mesenteric lymph node and thymus. Through replication, viremia occurs 1 to 5 days post infection, and then this virus is localized in epithelium of the oral cavity, esophagus, intestinal crypts, bone marrow, and of lymphatic tissues like thymus. If we talk about the clinical signs of the canine parvovirus, as we know that canine parvovirus 2 myocarditis form and acute enteritis form. First, myocarditis form, it occurs due to the in utero infection or the puppies which are born to the unvaccinated bitches. Usually, all puppies in a litter, they are found dead or succumbing within 24 hours after appearance of the clinical signs. The clinical signs of this myocarditis form include dyspnea, crying, retching. Retching is try to vomit. Acute enteritis form, it occurs in up to the 6 month of the age. Initial signs are non-specific, which include anorexia, depression, lethargy and fever. Later, typical signs appear like vomiting and small bowel diarrhea. We differentiate from small bowel diarrhea to large bowel diarrhea. Small bowel diarrhea is mucoid to hemorrhagic in nature. Also, there is marked abdominal dehydration and hypovolemic shock occurs. If we talk about the clinical pathology of this virus, then anemia, leukopenia, which is attributable to the lymphopenia, hyponatremia, hypochloremia and hypokalemia, metabolic acidosis, hypoalbuminemia and hypogammaglobulinemia occurs. But there is hyperalpha 2 globulinemia occurs. Alpha 2 globulin concentration increases. There is increase in burn, creatinine, inorganic phosphate, alanine transaminase and alkaline phosphatase enzyme. If we talk about the diagnosis of this virus, we can diagnose the virus by demonstrate the canine parvovirus in feces of dog. We can apply the techniques like electron microscopy, virus isolation, fecal hemagglutination, latex agglutination, real-time PCR, immunochromatography, or we can use serological tests like hemagglutination inhibition or ELISA. Treatment, we know supportive and symptomatic treatment is there. First one, fluid. Fluid requires is balanced electrolyte solution, which is isotonic to the blood. For example, RL solution or lactated Ringel solution, or dextrose 2.5 to 5%. In case of severe protein losing enteropathy, in which total protein less than 3.5 gram per deciliter, we can use non-protein colloid or hetastarch or dextran 70. In fresh frozen plasma, FFP, we can be given to provide the albumin or immunoglobulins. Second, broad spectrum antibiotics. We can use ampicillin with dose rate of 20 mg per kg IV 3 times a day, amoxicillin plus clavulonic acid 20 mg per kg, amikacin 20 mg per kg IV, IM subcut once time a day. Antiemetic drugs like metoclopromide with dose rate of 0.2 to 0.4 mg per kg subcut, prochlorperazine 0.1 to 0.5 mg per kg intramuscular or subcutaneous, ondansetron with dose rate of 0.1 to 0.2 mg per kg subcutaneous or IV. It also requires gastric protectants like famotidine 0.5 to 1 mg per kg, ranitidine 2 mg per kg, omeprazole 0.7 mg per kg. Then corticosteroids, they are useful in endotoxemia or endotoxic shock like dexamethasone with dose rate of 0.5 to 1 mg per kg, intravenous or subcutaneous. The point to be noted is antidiarrheal drugs are the contraindicated. Why? Because antidiarrheal drugs, they decrease the motility, and due to decreased motility, the toxins will absorb and endotoxemia will occur. So then if endotoxic shock or endotoxemia occur, then dexamethasone should be given. Then sixth one is immunotherapy. We can use immunotherapy recombinant feline interferon gamma with 2.5 million international unit per kg intravenous single a day for 3 consecutive days can be given. Antiviral drug oseltamivir phosphate and the brand name of Tamiflu with dose rate of 2 mg per kg orally 2 times a day for 5 days. For prevention, we can do the vaccination. Live attenuated vaccine, core vaccine, for example, DHPPIL, distemper, hepatitis, parvovirus, par influenza, leptospira. These are combination of all the virus vaccine, core vaccine, which can be given to 6 to 8 weeks of age, and after 3 to 4 weeks, second dose should be given. For this vaccine, onset of immunity starts in 1 to 2 weeks after the vaccination, and duration of this immunity for 1 to 3 year of age. Booster vaccination according to the schedule should be given 1 year later and then every 1 to 3 year. There is complete cross protection between canine parvovirus 2A and canine parvovirus 2B. Sodium hypochlorite is effective disinfectant against the parvovirus in canines.